Hey everyone, and welcome back to another episode on the channel. Today is episode number 2 of the Server Guys SMP. Apologies first off before we start of me not recording long. I've been on the server now for 6 months and I haven't released a episode for very long. So before this video starts, I do want to apologize for not being active on YouTube, but that's because I'm in year 11 now and this is my hobby. If you guys would like to see more content, make sure you leave a like and subscribe. As I'm going to say this at the end of the video, make sure you guys enjoy, and I'll see you guys in a second. But have fun. Alrighty, everyone. Now we're going to go and test out. We're going to see it. I've been told that we've had a prank. So we're going to check this out. It is at spawn. So we're going to go over the spawn here. Right now. And yeah. Oh my god. What has happened to our shop? Are you serious? Look, the reason it looks different, guys, from normal is because we are using the B00 resource pack that I've edited. We've got our GUI, and we're using the terracotta, official terracotta by B-dubs. What does it say? Belly up fish bar, the full run through incorporated. Alrighty, Tyler. I guess that's supposed to be upside down. Nope, that's not. There we go. A chair. Potions. Where's my stuff? Where did Tyler put my stuff? It's coming under here. Is it in? Where is my stuff? Sorry guys, I'm going straight from the shop to... Oh, here it is. It's all in here. Thank God. Alright, so I guess I'll have to fix that up. But anyway, let's have a look at the rest of the spawn. Oh, we're having a bit of door lag. So, teal shop's still here. Skyscraper's still there. There's something going on up there. I can't see it though. My kangaroo's still here that I haven't really changed. The potions shop has disappeared. A new shop downstairs. Okay. Looks like it's in production. Majority of this hasn't changed. The run throughs. Farms. Oh, this is new. What's down here? Current and only products. What's the shop name? Oh, we don't have Optifine 1.20 yet. A future place of Shopping Street 8. I don't know if that's a reference to something, but he seems to sell one diamond per stack of, the colored concrete powder. And he just has, he has this nearly every color. That's pretty cool. There's some terracotta. One diamond per stack of the terracotta. And there's sand. Okay. We're in a hole. I'm just gonna sleep. Sorry, I just did that just to check something that was actually still recording. The drug rug's still here. He can now name those because we're in 1.12. He can have a full stack, so I better let Jake know. This is Fluffy's store. It's been around for a while. He sells rockets, TNT, and gunpowder, but he's all out of stock, and he hasn't been all that active. The Easter egg board that I had, so that we've got 3 eggs left. I know where those eggs are. I'm gonna go and find them, and then we're gonna build and like a sort of desert where they're back over here. We're gonna build like a little memorial festival shop sort of thing of the Easter egg store. So they'll be coming hopefully next time. This is the like the temporary bridge. It can all fall down with one break of the, I believe it's a torch or a sign. They can all break down. So now over here, we're coming up to a project that the Fox and I worked on. If you watch Fox's videos, you'll see what I'm talking about. It's the log mill project. So yeah, we're working on this project. We're still finish it off, but we're getting there. We're getting some of the log types here, jungle wood that one is. And yeah, I built this whole section here, including the crane, and the Fox built this bit here. And then we worked together on the waterfall, and I need to check if I'm gonna get some ender pearls. I need to check to see if I have got myself a rabbit still up here, because we trapped a rabbit. Yep, because we've mucked around and we've called this one Teal, because Teal is currently busy doing our stuff, so he's not really active on the server anymore, but that's alright. Over here, Fox and I are wanting to build a little couple of stores here, like little houses for the log workers, and then hopefully get some trees up there. But yeah, we're nearly done, and we've changed what we're wanting to do over to the Nether project, which I'll have to do a quick cut, and I'll meet you guys over in the Nether project. Alrighty, everyone, welcome back to the Nether Hub. So the Nether Hub was started originally by Fox and I, and then Tyler and a lot of other people have come and helped out. So this is the design we're going for. That's terracotta up on the roof. I just have a different texture back. That's black terracotta. And so yeah, we've been working on this. This is the west tunnel, and each tunnel has its own direction, and then we're building a major tunnel, as you can probably see, lining up here. So this will go as far down that way as, like, keeps going until we reach the furthest person on that tunnel direction. So that'll be good. That one is to Lemon's, Captain Fluffy's, Tyler's, the End, and the Spider Farm. And so yeah, it goes down that way. And then this one is my one. So the Fox put on his latest episode, put the command block with number 4 in here, because it used to be just a colored command block, but we changed it to represent the seasons. And we also use concrete powder for the main design. We used to use the clay, which is now changed to terracotta. So yeah, and then the Nether brick there is colored black due to the texture pack. Now I just saw you guys would think it's a new mob, but it's just a retextured chicken to resemble what's going to go in my base. So I'm going to go show you guys what I've been working on my base. Now, in the next episode, hopefully Forge has come out, and Optifine and the replay mod have been released, so that I can show you in a 360 sort of like time-lapse sort of video of the project that I'm going to show you right now. So this is the super chunk, which is the community super chunk that I've built. So it's the Basement Incorporation super chunk. It is a slime farm on the bottom with farms all on the top around here. So we have slime balls come in, we have sugarcane, like a lot of sugarcane, cactuses, melons, pumpkins, and then I have my own AFK fish farm just there. So while I'm fishing, I can AFK. While I'm AFKing for product, I can just stand here and fish. So yeah, we've got a lot of stuff at the back here. A lot of this junk, really. I gotta sort of take it away. But we'll go down there and we'll have a look at the different farms so I can show you guys what the farms are and what they look like. And then we have an item elevator to bring all the items up. So that's pretty Gucci, very fine. So the slam block elevators, it's the same, it's module repeated. Impulse designed the sugarcane, and then he had the idea with the melon and pumpkin. I've just adapted it to fit into this into here, because I've built it sort of my own style. If you guys would like to see a tutorial, please let me know in the comments. I would love to do a tutorial. But yeah, that's sort of the stupid chunk, and then we have the slime down here, and in future episodes we'll move a couple of slime up into our park. So our prehistoric park is what we're building. So I'm gonna quickly do a quick cutscene of the introduction to our park, and I'll meet you guys over there.
There is something missing from our world. The amazing animals that time has left behind. But what if we could bring them back? What if extinction didn't have to be forever? We're going back in time on a safari with a difference. As wildlife adventure
Ace and CC.
plunges into prehistory to rescue creatures on the brink of extinction. His plan is to bring them back to the safety of the present and give them a second chance.
And welcome to Prehistoric Park, guys. So I've built this gate. It's actually the Jurassic Park gate. The link will be in the description of the creator who I built it off. But yeah, I've built this one. The stone brick has the different textures. It's still all stone brick. It's just different textures with the B00 texture pack. This bridge I custom designed. It's probably someone's already built it over already, but yeah. And then I built my little starter house. It used to be over there a bit, but I moved it over here just so it was out of the way. But yeah, it's a good little starter house. We got some shulker boxes. So right here I'm wanting to build the portal and cage. If you watch Prehistoric Park, then you would know what I'm talking about, with the portal and the cages when they first bring them back in time. And then I've built Bob, who's a major character. The main character in the series. I've built his little workshop area, and those crates are no blocks. So yeah, and then so that's Bob's workshop. I've given built Bob's little Bob's mobile, and so yeah, it's got like a little chest at the back, and yeah, and it's got a little house. And then we got Winx, the horse, speedy horse. We've got a random skeleton horse, Farlap. And then we also have black caviar, so yeah. And then we have a lot of wood, which was delivered to us by Upchuck Gaming. And then we have some puppies, and then we have our map of what our park is going to be. So as you can see over here, we've got the entrance to the park, and then there's a gate. Oh, I need to actually update this map. There we go. That's really weird, actually. And then we've got we're here, so I'm going to show you guys where this is going to be. The Triceratops Creek. So I've already built this, and then I'm currently in the currently producing the T-Rex Hill, which is over there, which we can update the map now. If we just walk over here a little bit, you can see it just all generate there, and the same as with this one, sort of. Yep. All right, so let's go back here, and then I'll quickly show you the enclosures I've built so far. So yeah, you can see that's sort of near our super chunk there. So Triceratops Creek, oh, I mean, was it Triceratops River? Yeah, Triceratops Creek. It's if we can, we can actually end up through this. Yep. It's sort of a little area with a little creek. we're gonna put some of our mobs. So we're gonna try and get every mob in the game into these pens. So I'm hoping to get either a polar bear or something like something on its four legs in here, just so it can we can call it like a triceratops sort of dinosaur or something. But yeah, hopefully get something like that and we'll move on. The reason I wanted like a polar bear or something is because I'm only needing one of them. I don't want to have two polar bears. If you watch the series, you'll understand what I'm talking about. We've got T-Rex Hill, which we've got to finish off getting all the grass in, so I'm going to go back over later after this episode, grab all the grass, and then finish the grass off camera, just because it's a painful project. But yeah, and then this is T-Rex Hill, so we'll have hopefully two T-Rexes, or two sort of big animals with a T-Rex, and I'll also build a little pixel art T-Rex in there as well, just to give it that cool little funny feel to it. But yeah, it's T-Rex Hill. The rest of this area is going to have different, like a raptor pen, mammoth hill. I'm just going to read you off my list. We're going to have triceratops treetops, I think by memory. Yeah, titanosaur treetops, sorry. T-Rex Hill. I got a little sheet of my little ones. Mammoth mount. The vet surgery, Nigel's den, bug house, and the big cat climb. So hopefully we can get those done on camera. If not, they'll be done in a replay. So yeah, and this is the Abdominus pond. So I did have chickens in here. I do have to go find them. I think I thought they were in here, but they might have escaped, but I think they've just despawned in the update, so we'll have to reboot some more of them in here. So yeah, there's a little hut sort of thing in here. You can just come and sit in. There's nothing in here. I'm just gonna put a torch actually in the centers there. So yeah, and that's pretty much it for this episode, I guess. Next episode we'll be definitely looking. Actually, I found the chickens. I found the one chicken. The one oppidimus. So we need to find. I think the other ones are somewhere else in the pen, but yeah, we're gonna have a hell of a lot in here. So anyway, there's another one, so they must have all moved around the map. But anyway, thank you guys for watching. Next episode we'll definitely, I'll be showing off another one of the replays of another project that I've done, just because this episode's probably going for a little bit too long now. But I hope you guys enjoy. Make sure to hit that like button, make sure to leave a comment, and make sure you guys subscribe for more content. There'll be hopefully there will already been in the channel update video, which will be in the end cards for you guys to look at, but there will be also a couple of new series not on computer stuff in the channel, so hopefully you guys enjoy that.
I've been around the world a couple of times and maybe more, seen the sights, I've had delights on every foreign shore, but when my mates all ask me the place that I adore, I tell them right away. What do we tell them? Give me a home among the gum trees, with lots of plum trees, a sheep or two, a kangaroo, a clothesline out the back, veranda out the front, and an old rocking chair. You can see me in the kitchen, cooking up a roast, or Vegemite on toast, just you and me, a cup of tea. Later on, we'll settle down.